We've learned how to use a Jiang4 macro command tracking variables to let Jiang4 print more information on screen, such as the particle name, the track ID, the parent track ID, the locations, kinetic energy, and energy deposition of the particle, in what kind of volumes, and through what kind of physics process. This kind of Jiang4 output is formatted in a way that is easy for people to understand, but it is hard to parse in a program for statistical analysis. Jiang4 provides four output formats that are easier for a machine to understand. Through a series of analysis manager classes, they are Root, HDF5, XML, and CSV. XML and CSVs are pure text files. Root and HDF5 are binary files. Given the same amount of information, binary files occupy less storage space, are faster to read than pure text files. If you simulate a few thousands of events, XML and CSV would be able to handle it. However, if you simulate millions of events, binary format might be a much better choice. Both Root and HDF5 are designed for fast processing of huge amount of data. Root is mostly used by particle physicists, while HDF5 is used in many other fields. As a data analysis framework, Root provides a lot of analysis tools in addition to the definition of the Root file format. However, you don't have to install Root to save Jiang4 output in Root format. On the other hand, you will have to install HDF5 library to save Jiang4 output in HDF5 format. The pre-compiled Jiang4 libraries that you can download from the Jiang4 website do not have HDF5 support enabled. That's why Gears use Root as its default output format. If you have HDF5 enabled in your Jiang4 installation, you can easily enable HDF5. You can use the macro command analysis set file name to specify the output file name. Note that no suffix is needed for the file name. What's saved in a Gears output file are variables of every step point in a simulated event. Jiang4 tracks particles step by step as it passes through the simulated world until it goes out of it or gets absorbed. A step point is a point where a particle track is generated or changed. A step point in Gears contains the following information: track ID, step number, detector volume number, process ID, particle ID, local positions, local time, global positions and global time, kinetic energy, momentum, charge, so on and so forth. Normally, a simulated event may have many step points, and the number of step points varies from event to event. That's why arrays with variable sizes are needed to save those variables. In C++, arrays with variable sizes are called vectors. That's why vectors are used in Gears to save those variables. Jiang4 provides a class called G4 User Step in Action for a user to grab information from Jiang4 and save it to an output file. However, this class only provides access to step 1 and afterwards. No information of step 0 can be fetched this way. Gears uses G4 stepping variables instead of G4 user stepping action for data recording. The former provides a function called tracking started to fetch information about step 0. This is how Gears saves the full information of a Jiang4 simulation. A detector may have many components. Normally, you are only interested in the information in some of the components. When you place a detector component in the world in the text geometry definition file, you can assign a volume copy number to each of them. If you assign a negative number to a volume, gears will not record any step points inside that volume. The world has a volume number 0 by default, and the step points in it will not be recorded. This is how you turn on and off the recording of step points in a specific volume in gears. The sensitive part of your detector may be able to record the total energy deposited in it. To tell gears which part of a detector is sensitive, you can simply add a string, parenthesis s at the end of its name. The name of the array used to save the total energy is called ET, or energy total. The index of the array is the same as the copy number of the sensitive volume. So ET1 is the total energy recorded by the sensitive volume 1, and ET2 would be the total energy recorded by sensitive volume 2. And since the copy number of all sensitive volume has to be bigger than 0, ET0 is used to store the total energy deposited in all sensitive volumes. Now let's take a concrete example to help us understand the concept better. There is a macro file called radiate.mac in the gears examples output directory. It is used to study the response of a germanium detector to 2.6 MeV gamma rays. We specify the output file name using the macro command analysis set file name. After we run the simulation, I got a output file called output.root. You can now use root output.root to open it. You can then use .ls to check what's in it. You can see that there is a root tree in it called t. It saves the GM4 step points information. You can then use t show 0 to show the contents of the first event. The meaning of individual variables are explained in detail on the Gears website. The sensitive volume in this simulation is a cylindric germanium crystal located inside a vacuum can. It has a volume copy number 1. In root, you can use such a simple command to draw the statistical distribution of the total energy deposit in volume 1. You can display the spectrum in linear or log scale. You can move individual components in different places on the canvas. You can also zoom into the region that you are interested in by dragging along the axis. You can draw 2D or even multiple dimensional histograms using a column to separate two variables. If you are only interested in the XY distribution in the sensitive volume that has a copy number equal to 1, you can add a step point selection criteria, volume equal to 1, in the join function. You can also change the default join option to display the result in a more meaningful way. You can use straight lines to connect the XY coordinates of step points of the first particle that has a track ID equal to 1 in the same canvas for event number 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, or 9. The standard PDG encoding of the particles is used as a particle ID. So you can draw the PDG distribution and figure out that most of the stepping points are associated with gamma rays that has a PDG number 22. Many of them are associated with electrons, which has a PDG number 11. Some of them are associated with positrons, which has a PDG number minus 11. An integer called PRO is used to indicate the physics process associated with each step point. Number 1091 is used to represent transportation. We can use this criteria to draw the process distribution other than transportation. Number 2002 is the ionization of electrons created by primary gamma rays. 2003 are bremsstrahlung of electrons. 2005 are annihilation of electron and positrons. 2010 is multiple scattering of electrons. 2011 is Rayleigh scattering of the primary gamma rays. 2012 is the photoelectric effect of gamma ray. And 2013 is the component scattering of gamma rays. And 2014 is the pair production of the primary gamma ray. From the height of the individual bars, one can tell that electrons mostly does ionization and multiple scattering, while gamma rays mostly do component scattering. Using various combinations of those variables, you can understand a lot more about the simulation in addition to what we have demonstrated here.